in the previous the partition of Bengal and the different phases of partition of Bengal. So once again I'm going to repeat that part and then we'll end the class. Okay, so I'm going to share my screen, so just go through that. Okay, so anti-partition movement, that is Swadeshi and boycott movement. So see here, it is divided into number of phases altogether. Five phases were there in the anti-partition movement. Okay, the first phase, you see what happened actually, that is on 16th October 1905, the people observed that day as a very sad day. It is termed as a mourning day. Day was very, very sad for them. The people started walking and singing the famous song Banglar Mati, Banglar Jol, composed by Rabindranath Tagore particularly for that occasion. And even people observed Raksha Bandhan, so tying threads between Hindus and Muslims, and that was a bond of brotherhood among both the Hindus and the Muslims. And in the evening, a conference was arranged in the Calcutta town hall, where speakers from different courses, they spoke on the anti-partition movement and all. Okay, one after another, they expressed their feelings, their sentiments were very much hurt due to this partition. That is why they spoke on that. They were given the platform. Even some of the Muslim leaders like Abul Kahim, okay, Din Muhammad, Dawar Box, and Liaquat Hussain joined the protest movement. So many more. So in the first phase, the movement was very, very peaceful. The movement was very, very peaceful, my dear. Okay. So here is a term, the mammoth. Mammoth means a large, then huge crowd of people is known as mammoth. Representation of the signatures. That means 7,000 people are belonging to different communities and classes. They signed a letter and they submitted to the secretary of the state. Okay. Even the doors planters protested against it. So this was simply a very, very silent protest. We can say that the movement was completely done in a peaceful way. They did not go violently against the British government. Okay. So the first phase of the anti-partition movement was a very peaceful and a very calm way. There are no such type of violence incurred in the anti-partition movement of the first phase. Okay. Now, slowly and gradually, it did not mean that only one day the movement took place. Later on, again, the movement was continued further with different agendas and all. So in the next phase, we can see that the movement in the second phase was all about Atma Shakti. That means to making oneself very, very strong and making oneself comfortable for the self-help. Okay. And Rabindranath Tagore, Ashwini Kumar Datta, and other leaders appealed to the Bengali nation. The people of Bengal were appealed by Rabindranath Tagore, Ashwini Kumar Datta to start Atma Shakti or a self-help movement. We need to help ourselves. Okay, and even Rabindranath Tagore asked the countrymen to organize constructive activities instead of appealing to the British authority. That means instead of appealing, appealing means requesting the British authority, they were requested to start a constructive activities. Okay, like some of the poets also laid down the program of constructive activities like vernacular education, social reform, reform in the society was also very, very important. Okay, then next one you can see. Organization. So you can see here these three names. I'm going to mention it over here. You must remember it. Very, very important for the short questions like Satish Chandra Mukherjee. Satish Chandra Mukherjee led the foundation of Down Society. And what was the main purpose of Down Society? The main purpose of Down Society was to give effect the idea of national education. Okay. If you are asked what is the purpose of Down Society, you have to write it answer. It was to give effect to the idea of national education. Now, another one was Ashwini Kumar Datta. Remember the names. Ashwini Kumar Datta founded a Braj Mohan College at Barsal that is now in Bangladesh. Then Sir P.C. Roy and Dr. Neil Ratan Sarkar and now open Indigenous Factories and Trading Society. So these all are constructive programs led by the people of Bengal, requested by Rabindranath Tagore. And many other leaders. Now in the third phase, little bit of passive resistance was incurred in the third phase. now they started to go for a Swadeshi and boycott movement. Okay, now what is boycott? What is Swadeshi? Boycott means to avoid foreign goods, and Swadeshi means to use the goods made in our country. So that way, Swadeshi was a constructive program and boycott was a destructive program. Okay, so both were complementary to each other. So it was very, very necessary for the people to understand the effect of Swadeshi and boycott movement. So in the third phase, much preferences were given to Swadeshi and boycott movement. Now, it is mentioned by Bipin Chandra Pal, one of the extremist leader. He has mentioned that he has strongly criticized the petition prayer policy of the moderates. Bipin Chandra Pal and all, they were not happy with the policy followed by the moderates, because at that time moderates also were there, like Dadabhai Naroji was there, Gopal Krishna Gokhale was there, Surendranath Banerjee was there. So the partition of Bengal took place during that tenure only. But when they failed to stop the partition of Bengal, then the extremist leaders came forward to stop the partition of Bengal. So here, you can see here in his famous pamphlet, New Lamps for Old, Aurobindo Ghosh. You must remember this also. New Lamps for Old was a pamphlet introduced by Aurobindo Ghosh. And through this pamphlet, Aurobindo Ghosh appealed to the people to rally for foreign forging powerful active movement. That means now they wanted the movement to become more and more active. So he declared in 1907, this movement is no mere a protest against ill government of Raj. So this movement is not against the government. This movement is now directed against Raj and Sikh. It's end. They wanted to end the British Raj from our country. Raj means R-A-J, Raj means they were referring to the British rule or the British Raj. Okay, so many more are there. This we don't need to discuss over it. Now, in the fourth phase, the students also took part in the movement. Student volunteered and they took active part in the Swadeshi and boycott movement. What did they do? They started picketing before the shops. Picketing means stopping the people to get into the shops where foreign goods were sold. They're made to understand, please don't buy the foreign goods. Okay, so directly not in front of the shop, little bit far away from the shop they stood, and they requested the people or the customers going toward the shop selling foreign goods to avoid the use of foreign goods. Okay, the next one you can see here, in the fifth phase or in the same phase, fourth phase only, many of the progressive that means development took place, like as a boycott movement strongly was followed by all the people of Bengal. So Swadeshi stores definitely was required. So definitely last time also I told you that if you are boycotting Chinese goods, then the alternative to the Chinese goods must be there. There will be a demand for alternatives of substitute of the Chinese goods. In the same way, number of industries such as Calcutta Potteries, Bengal Chemical, Banga Lakshmi Cotton Mill, okay, Mohini Mill, National Tannery were started. Apart from this, many soap, matchbox, okay, soap, matchbox, tobacco manufacturing establishment, oil mill, Swadeshi banks, insurance companies were also open as a result of Swadeshi movement. So this is all about a constructive program initiated by Rabindranath Tagore and all. So Rabindranath Tagore also encouraged initiating number of Swadeshi stores. So all this took place in the fourth phase. In the fourth phase, all these things took place. Okay. And in the final phase, that is in the fifth phase, anti-partisan movement took a character of revolutionary terrorism. So the young groups, like we can say that many of the people were not happy with the work of moderate. That is why there was a rise of extremism. There was a rise of extremism. So when the moderates failed, there was a rise of extremism. When extremists also could not fulfill or achieve their demands, then there was a young group, frustrated youth. They resorted to violence. They were ready to resort to any sort of violence. Okay, like young group, like you people don't have patience, right? You cannot tolerate anything injustice being done to you. You're ready to fight for your right. The same way that time also young groups were there who were ready to do anything to achieve freedom from the British rule. So moderates failed, the extremists failed. Extremists, when they started, within the extremist movement only, a terrorist group also, terrorist group means I'm not talking about those terrorists today, which we understand. Some terrorist organizations also became very, very active. Their main motive was to kill the British officers, to instill fear in the minds of the Britishers. That they decided. So let us once again look into this last part, that is the fifth phase of the national movement. So you can see in the fifth phase, anti-partisan movement took a character of revolutionary terrorism. See the term, revolutionary terrorism, the brutal repression. So you can, now you can see here, from this phase onward, the government becomes more and more repressive. Okay, the brutal repression, torture on the innocent people, drove a section of youth to a path of revolutionary terrorism under the inspiration of Aurobindo Ghosh and his brother Barindra Ghosh. The revolutionary leaders now plan to murder the repressive officers. Now you can see here, plan to offer the repressive officers and the magistrate. Okay, so I think you people are familiar with this type of activities when a youth is tortured by the police and all. In Hindi movies and all, you might have seen, right? When are tortured or not given jobs and all, they take a path of violence. Have you seen or not? A hero becomes a villain and tries to take revenge with the government authorities and all. They try to kill them and all. So that happens due to certain reason. The reasons are this, my dear. When they don't get jobs, when their demands are not fulfilled, when they follow a straight path, and when they are obstacled, when obstacle comes in the path of these people, then there is no other option left for them. So everybody cannot be made understood that no, this is a wrong path, don't follow this. So what they do is that they take a wrong path, and there they decided to kill the British magistrate and all, because they were the one torturing the people, arresting the people and all, and brutal repressions were there. Lathi charges were done, they are beaten, they are flogged and all, they were taken to the prisons and all. All this thing forced these young people to get into the terrorist activities and all. This thing happened in the fifth phase. This all thing happened in the fifth phase. So if you are asked about the phases of the anti-partisan movement, thus you must remember, my dear, one by one, all the phases in short, you have to mention it. What happened in the first phase, what happened in the second phase, third phase, fourth phase, and the last phase. So all these paragraphs you have to, it is not that a whole thing you have to copy it down from the same book. You can make it. All the important points, you can take it out from that paragraph and make it into small, small paragraphs, which you can easily understand and make the teacher also understand. Did you understand? These are the phases of the anti-partisan movement from this chapter. Assessment of Swadeshi movement. So when you see anti-partisan movement taking place, as a person, what is your opinion? How will you assess the anti-partisan movement? So you can see here, it is mentioned here by Amlesh Tripathi. You can see, though the movement started with a bang, it ended with a whimper, remarked Amlesh Tripathi. So movement started with a bang, but finally it was ended. So what were the causes of failure of the anti-partisan movement? Why did the movement fail? The first one, the ruthless repression, iron handling by the authority, indiscriminate lathi charge. Indiscriminate lathi charge, you can see here, without discrimination, buda hai, jawan hai, kya hai, aurat hai, kya hai, sabko jab danda lagna shuru to sabko mara, kisi par discriminate nahi kiya, barabari se danda lagaya sabko. Okay, so ruthless repression, iron handling by the authority, indiscriminate lathi charge, arrest, imprisonment broke the morale of the volunteers and picketers. Okay, that means their strength, inko jo josh tha ki ab anti-partition ko aage le jana hai, rokna hai, sab inka ye jo taakat tha sab khatam kar diya. Kisne? Government ne, police ka danta ne sab ko thanda kar diya. Okay, next one you can see here. Split in the Surat Congress 1907. So what is this Surat split? You can see that every year Congress sessions were held in different places, my dear. And one such session took place in Surat. Or the 1907, the Surat session took place there was a split between the moderates and the extremists. Moderates and extremists were separated. Okay, and this weakened the anti-partisan movement. So Bipin Chandra Pal thinks that though the Swadeshi movement had spread outside Bengal, the rest of the country was not yet prepared to adopt the new style and technique. Though the movement, anti-partisan movement, that was of a Swadeshi and boycott movement, though it is spread out of Bengal, बंगाल से बाहर भी फैल गया, बट दैट वॉज नॉट एट ऑल द पीपल आउटसाइड बंगाल वॉज नॉट प्रिपेयर टू अडॉप्ट द न्यू स्टाइल एंड द टेक्निक. डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड? सो इन 1907 इन द सूरत कांग्रेस माई डियर, द मॉडरेट्स एंड द एक्सट्रीमिस्ट वेयर सेपरेटेड बिकॉज द व्यूज ऑफ बोथ द मॉडरेट्स एंड एक्सट्रीमिस्ट वेयर डिफरेंट. Moderates way they did not want to give up their policy of prayer and petition, whereas extremists they wanted to go with Swadeshi and boycott movement. Okay. Now another important fact was that there was a sudden vacuum of leadership. So that means leaders were missing out because Bipin Chandra Pal has mentioned that between 1907 and 1908, nine important leaders, okay, of the movement, including Ashwini Kumar Datta, Krishna Kumar Mitra of Bengal, were deported. Deported means third part, Bengal se dusre jagah le jana. Okay, they were shifted to other places, so their activeness was missing. Okay, and Tilak was given 6 years of imprisonment. Tilak was imprisoned for how many years? 6 years. Ajit Singh, Lala Lajpat Rai of Punjab were also deported. Bipin Chandra Pal, Arvind Ghosh, they retired from the active politics. In log boode ho gaye. Okay, and entire movement completely became leaderless. So there was a that means a movement completely became leaderless due to all this thing. Many of the leaders were deported. Tilak was very very active. He was imprisoned for 6 years. Okay, then movement was mainly confined to middle class people. Middle class means who all are called middle class. Who all are called middle class? Middle class are the people, we are the people belonging to middle class. Na zyada ameer hai, na gareeb hai, hum log beech mein hai. Hai na? Educated, like teachers, professors, doctors, engineers, all these people comes under the middle class. High class people are rich, businessmen and all, they belong to the higher class. Lower class people, poor people and all. We are in the middle. So, what happened in the middle class people, you can see here, that it could not take into a mass character. The leaders of Swadeshi movement did not try to rally the peasants. Peasants also were not brought into the national Bengal movement. Okay, so it was considered, that means only the elite group, that is a middle class group, the educated people who really understood the effect of partition of Bengal, they rallied against the British government. They wanted the partition of Bengal to be stopped. The rest of the other people, they were completely indifferent with the anti-partition movement. Unka saath nahi tha Bengal partition mein. Okay. Now next one you can see here. What about the Muslim people? Did they take part in the anti-partition movement? I cannot say that everybody did not take part, but very few were there who took part in the anti-partition movement. And many of the important leaders of the Muslims, they remained silent and they supported strongly. Okay, they supported the British government and they strongly opposed the Swadeshi and anti-partition movement. Because before the plan of Swadeshi movement was implemented, my dear, as I told you that Lord Curzon had toured, that means eastern part of Bengal, Dhaka, wahan ja karke Muslim logo se mila. Or they were convinced that you don't take part in the anti-partition movement because the partition is done in such a way that this territory where Muslims will be in majority will rule over your territory. Aap log yahan rule kar paoge. You will be the rulers of the Muslim majority territory. They were convinced by Lord Curzon. That is why the maximum Muslim people, Muslims of Bengal, they remain indifferent in the national movement. They did not take part in the anti-partition movement. Not all. Few were there who took part in the anti-partition movement. Okay. Then next one you can see that another side you can see a narrow Hindu character of Swadeshi movement also made the general Muslim indifferent towards the movement. Now what is this all about? I'll explain you. This is all about that narrow Hindu character. So, jabhi bhi, as I say, Hindus and Muslims were together during that time during the partition of Bengal, my dear. But taking oath in front of Goddess Kali, taking bath in river Ganga. So, all these are religious thing in the anti-partition movement. So, that will not be accepted by the Muslim communities, right? Right, Bhagwan temple mein ja karke puja karna. That is correct, That is right way they want to get strength from Goddess Kali and all. But these Muslim people were made in understand by other people that this movement is a Hindu movement. Ye log Hindu character movement hai. They are doing against your religion, right? So this also kept the Muslims far away from the partition of Bengal, the anti-partition movement. So you know that British played a policy of divide and rule. दोनों के माइंड में जहर घोलने का काम किसने किया? ब्रिटिशर्स दे दी रही थी. ब्रिटिशर्स प्लेड द पॉलिसी ऑफ डिवाइड एंड रूल फ्रॉम द वेरी बिगनिंग. लाइक मुस्लिम्स एंड हिंदूस वे द सेम आईज ऑफ द सेम ब्राइट इंडिया. दो आंखें थे लेकिन क्या हुआ, इनके बीच में जहर किसने घोला? ब्रिटिशर्स. दे प्लेड अ कम्युनल इंस्टिल कम्युनल हेट्रेड इन द माइंड ऑफ द मुस्लिम्स ऑल्सो. दे वेर सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम द एंटी पार्टीशन मूवमेंट. सो ऑल दिस थिंग हैपन्ड माई डियर. एंड ऑल दिस वेर द कॉजेस for the failure of anti-partition movement. Okay, itna bada movement khatam kaise hua, right? How did this movement come to an end? So these are the reasons I discuss right now. Okay, so this is the end of the first part of this chapter, my dear. Okay, end of this first part. Two units are there in this chapter. The first part we have completed and the second part we'll discuss in the next class. Okay, first part of this chapter we have completed. Okay, children. So thank you for tolerating me. So we'll meet again in the next class. Okay, that is on Saturday. Till then, take care, stay safe, and bye-bye.
Bye, sir.